we're in a period of chaos. We're in a period of chaos, and in a period of chaos, the time horizon shrinks because the outcome is uncertain. Well, this seems.
So Santa Fe, right, where all the magic of complex systems goes down and then comes out and then wiggles around like a Lorenz attractor, right? So I'm going to show you clips from the Complexity Explorer with the professors showing what he's meaning, or I should say a mathematics professor that studies dynamical systems, what he means by it getting shorter.
And in a period of chaos, the time horizon shrinks.
Looking at period doubling, and here's, again, this picture. We have period doubling from 2 to 4, 4 to 8, and so on. Capital delta is the range of parameter values for which we have period 2. Delta 2 is the next range. Delta 3 is the next range. And we define these ratios, this divided by this, this divided by that, to be these little deltas. And for the logistic equation.
So Jordan Peterson was talking about an actual real thing. We kind of know the phrase chaotic, but what's important here is period doubling and the route in chaos and how often the system keeps changing itself. And there's no better place to do that than through the University of Santa Fe in New Mexico, the Institute of Complex Systems.
And in a period of chaos, the time horizon shrinks.
So again, the phenomenon of universality, with delta n approaching a number delta, and we say that delta is universal. And the result is that this number delta is the same, 4.669201, for all iterated functions that map an interval to itself and have a single quadratic maximum. So this is not a very restrictive criteria. So any function you come up with that meets these very mild criteria, you can make a bifurcation diagram, find the bifurcation points like we did, calculate the deltas, go deeper and deeper, let n get larger and larger, and this number will appear. So this number is a property of all of those functions.
And in a period of chaos, the time horizon shrinks.
And so you might be thinking to yourself, well, yeah, that might be that system, but what about, you know, human systems have to be way different than these mathematical models and things that are going on. It turns out that that's false. All complex systems have this period doubling, right? And that's very, very important. And in fact,
number 4.669. And that's an interesting result for the logistic equation. It's a perhaps a little mathematical oddity, tells us about the geometry of this particular bifurcation diagram. Then we looked at bifurcation diagrams for other equations, quite different equations, sines and cubes as well as parabolas, and we saw the same general features of the bifurcation diagram. But then if we calculate these deltas, and we kept calculating them to larger and larger periods, we would find again the same number appearing, 4.669. So that's where things started to get really weird, that we're seeing the equations or the details of the equations don't matter. There's some broader or overarching feature of these systems that's independent of the particular equation that we use. So that's something deep and something pretty surprising, I think. But this is physics as well. Period doubling occurs in real physical systems, and one can go out and measure the rates at which those period doubles, those period doublings occur, and one finds again this number 4.669. So I'll describe that result in the next lecture.
In fact, if you go through history, it basically kind of shows us that we had to basically keep inventing things faster and faster and faster to keep ourselves from going into this chaotic period. So inventions, technologies stabilize the attractor states of the system to make sure that the structures maintain themselves. And here we can think of the structures as governments, laws, culture, society, which then basically set up the rules and boundaries of, helped to influence the rules and boundaries and attractor states and repressor states for human behavior. are ways around this. I suggest you, or anyone who's interested in this, to look at David Snowden, not related to Edward, as far as I can tell. I mean, science to all humans are related thing. But he's ahead of his time. He's done a lot of great work. We need to... manage the evolutionary potential of the present and not idealize the system for a future state.
Which actually means we need to manage in the present. And this is one of the huge differences between systems thinking and complexity thinking. And complexity is probably the biggest paradigm shift in thinking about management in the last 40 or 50 years. In systems thinking, whether it's re-engineering, Porter's Five Forces, or at the fluffy Benny end, Peter Senge Learning Organization, defines an ideal future state and tries to close the gap. And of course, it never gets there. Complexity says what matters is accurately describing the present. Out of the things in the present you can change, where can you monitor the effect of the change and effectively move to a safe to fail experimental management of the present to evolve forwards to a future state which is more sustainable and more resilient? And that's a radical shift. The interesting thing is what entrepreneurs do all the time, but they forget when they become big companies. So managing in the present is one of the key new themes, or as I sometimes phrase it, managing the evolutionary potential of the present, rather than constantly failing to achieve an idealized future state, which might not be the best place to get to anyway. And that's actually key. This is sometimes called intrapreneurship from people at Wharton and elsewhere.
One of the problems with progressives is they deal with that area in their head, and I'm using Jordan Peterson's words here, of what ought to be and not what is. And this is why progressives and social scientists don't always get along with hard sciences, you know, physics, chemistry, biology. However, clearly there are some really good social scientists out there. This person, for example, Claire Lehman, I found her on Twitter and I've been following her for a while. Actually, I think she might have found me. Great, she follows a lot of great people. This guy's another good social scientist. Mechanism is where reality manifests itself.